Hello, folks. Welcome back to Play It Again. This is Red Clock, and we're currently playing Castlevania Harmony of Despair for the PlayStation 3. So, let's get started. This is pretty much a new copy of the game. I had this for Xbox 360, which I'm lending out to a friend right now. And I have some upgrades and stuff. I haven't proceeded to another level other than the first on normal difficulty. So, you'll get a view of my gear. I'll show you. Actually, let me show you what my gear is right now. No. Okay. Sorry, wrong button. Let's go to local play. Status menu. There we go. Offensive gear. I got this thing. How do you pronounce that? Ghost. Someone ghost familiar. That's one of the souls. Minotaur, it's another soul, increases strength, skeleton, throws bones, axe knight, throws axe, Maloric sniper, summons an archer to support you, and the boss, Gurgoth, I think it's how he pronounced his name. I've gotten some of his souls. They're pretty rare to get, souls from bosses. But I have three of them so far, and I think I only fought them maybe like 15, 20 times. Defensive gear. Ballroom mask. There we go. Let's see. Gambler glasses. If you wear them and you go to your monster catalog, they'll show you the item drops and the souls, how rare they are, like percentage-wise of killing a monster. Ballroom mask is what I have now. Gym clothes. This is better protection here, but the gym clothes are better for attack as of now. Iron leggings. Assassin's cape, which I think brings up my attack as well. Power belt on. Two power belts. I have lucky charms that bring up your luck, and I'm not really too concerned about that right now. And I could use a high potion right now, but I choose not to. So let's exit. And let's get started. Of course, I'll show you the shop later on. I bought some items. I have a handgun equipped. I forgot to tell you about that, too. On his other hand. Alright, so we press R3 to zoom in. And we're playing as Soma right now. Which I usually play as Soma. I think I played as Alucard a few times. I did beat this on the Xbox 360. But I figured I'd just give this a fresh start on the PlayStation 3. That's pretty much the only reason why I bought the Xbox 360 was just to play this. This sword here has a ability to poison enemies, which doesn't work very well, by the way. Only a few enemies seem like they can get poisoned. And of course, when you start this game, you're not this powerful as I am right now. Coffee, a food item. You start off with an axe and regular clothes, and the axe is very slow. It's not very powerful. You gotta swing at enemies a few times, so you can't really go through this that fast. There we go. There's my gun. It's not that powerful. Damn you. Yeah, I will get better. I think on the hard difficulty. Here's a hidden item. On the hard difficulty, it's a bell. I was able to go through level 6, which is Dracula's castle. Damn these guys. And I was able to do it without getting hit once. There's a soul right there. I'm just going through this route here because I want to get all the chests. This is a great sword for the normal levels, by the way. Hoop earring. It just brings up your defense on your accessories. Watch out for that laser beam. That's actually being shot by the boss, by the way. Or gamma ray, or what you want to call it. Yeah, you have an action button to open chests and to, oh, messed that one up. There's a monocle. They also drop gambler glasses as well when you kill those things. Standing right in front of the gun and couldn't get hit. So, you can get boots eventually that make you run faster. Right now I'm running pretty damn slow. I like to kill every enemy I can. Oh wow, I actually got him. I want to go to the left first. And you want to get the food items, even though you don't need to eat food. You do need to eat food, but you don't need health. They bring up your strength and other things as well. You got a pendant, I'm sorry. I noticed one thing that's good for attacking. When you jump up, notice this real quick. When you jump up and you swing, you can swing again real fast when you land. Money. Money's good for shopping, of course. I think you already knew that. When you do your double jump, you press down and jump again, and you can dive down with your foot and hit an enemy. You get the Grasshopper Trophy, or if you're playing Xbox 360 achievement, if you attack someone for so many jumps in a row. I already got that, by the way. That's the only trophy I think I have on this so far. I'm letting myself get hit pretty much here. Well, it's my first time playing this game and talking, too. I had another recording, actually. But for some reason, my computer messed up, and the sound and the video was unsynchronized. Like attacking those Axemen from behind. That way, you don't have to knock over their shield, and you can get them one hit whenever you have the sword equipped. Of course, down and jumps through platforms, certain platforms. Thin ones, not the thicker ones. That was close. And I think every video I'm just going to do a run through of the levels just for one video, and maybe I'll mess around. Here you go, open your book, and you can equip other items if you want to. If you're in the middle of the level and you need to change something. Here's the boss's soul, by the way. Of course, I just wasted that. Bandana, that's for your head. The head slot. Alright, let's get this food and get out of here. I did pretty good there. There's this one soul I need is a Medusa head. And then I can get this one chest in this level. But I don't have the Medusa head, so I can't really get it. Medusa head would help you here right here, too. It makes you float. And I haven't played any other levels on my own time yet. Because I wanted to show you what items you can receive for a different level. The shop will probably unlock some more items. Axeman Soul, I got all nine of those. I'm guessing the... Actually, I think you get 10 or 9. I can't remember. But, what was I saying? I forgot. Here's where the Medusa Head Soul would come into play. Right here, because just to be able to get to the other side, I can get up here, just barely. And get... Purple chest has better stuff in it, usually. Come here. There you go. And certain attacks, the souls, when you receive so many souls, it'll upgrade. Of course, fried chicken's used for food in the food slot. Here's the axe. Oops, wrong button. That's as big as it gets. Sometimes when you collect souls, you get all 9 or 10. I can't remember exactly how much. I'm going to have to look into that. When you get so many, some of the powers are ridiculously huge. You can only, these zombies seem like they're going to keep spawning, but they don't. They'll eventually die out. Sometimes when you jump up and hit the axe armor's head, you'll hit his head instead of the shield, which is a good thing. Now, how the hell did he get all the way down here already? Damn it. I need to pay attention to what I'm doing. Get up here, you son of a bitch. I like it when they drop items. Of course, I think everybody likes that. Oh, okay, I gotta open that door. Yeah, you pretty much have to clear all the enemies there and go back and open the door, because I seriously doubt you can kill all those enemies fast enough before you get through there, unless you're really good. Which there's probably some of you out there that can do that already. I just don't have the right weapons yet. I want to kill that flea man. I want his soul. Yeah, damn it. It's alright. Flea men don't give up souls very easily. We already got the enemies in this room because they came down to me, which I like. Damn it. Missed. There's a hidden room in this level too, which I will get to. Getting through this pretty fast. Hidden food here. Hidden in the wall. I notice you do a lot of that back and forth jumping on platforms in Castlevania games, especially like in Symphony of the Night. Probably has some nerdy term out there, but I don't sure as hell know it. Someone's gonna leave a comment and... Alright, there we go. I'm not too worried about killing all the ghosts. Oh, so many drop a war axe, or whatever the hell it's called. Battle axe. I can turn around and sell that. Well, this isn't the most powerful sword. I gotta take that back. Here's the boss. There's one's more powerful, but this is most powerful for its speed. Usually you get 29 on that, or 27, I can't remember. Here come the ghosts that followed me from before. I meant to bounce on him. There we go. Got in that secret room. Or hidden room. Or I don't know if it's a secret or what. Hiking boots. Sell those. What's in here? Fedora. I don't think I need that. I don't know if I have received that yet or not. See, when you collect the food, it brings up, most of it will bring up your strength, and you'll be able to hit them more, or hit them with harder. When you hit his feet are guarded, so you only get 11. Of course, I'm pretty strong right now, and I don't care if I get hit. That's how I killed him when I first played this. Because I killed him the first time I played this level, even though I had a shitty weapon. I just kept doing this. Usually when you kill him, you'll say, gotcha. Yeah, like you just did. Here's the treasure chest. Open it up, see what we got. Combat boots. That's something new. I'll have to check into that. Beat this pretty fast. I'm surprised. I'll take you through some of the things in this game, some of the features. Alright, so what we're going to do now, status menu, defensive gear. Okay, let's look at that hat. Do we need it? Fedora. No, we do not. But let's equip the gambler glasses right now. Alright, and let's see, what else do we need? The boots. Let's see, sandals, combat boots. Brings your defense down, but it raises your attack up to 25. You know what? I'm not too worried about getting hurt right now. I'm pretty tough. So I'm going to equip those. And now I'm still going to keep the iron leggings just in case if I need defense. So what we're going to do is exit out of here. Compendium, I think is how you pronounce that monster. Here we go. We got the gambler glasses on. So zombie, we'll see first. We got all his souls. Hobo's clothes, 4.5%. Souls are received at 2.5%. And when you have a soul eater ring, which you can get, I think you can get two of them. It'll raise it up higher with both of them. As you can see, we see the monsters we've seen already. When you don't have an item yet, that's what sucks. It doesn't tell you what the percentage rate is of it. So, let's see. I'd like to get a peeping eye soul, because then you could see through walls. Let's see what else we got. How much time do I got to have? Well, I got like 10 minutes. See, I think I got Bone Pillar. I can't remember what exactly his soul does. Then there's an enemy here. I don't know if it's hidden or what. I'd like to find out what that enemy is. And there's Gurgoth. His souls are at 0.5%. And I have 4, I guess. Alright. Here's your items. You can see a list of items that you've received or seen, or I'm not too sure. Controller settings, sound settings, window settings, screen settings. You can stretch the screen or shrink it. Camera settings. That's where you press R3 to change your camera. Or you can use the right stick to move the camera. So now we're going to go to the shop. Yeah, let's see. We're going to sell some stuff. Start on items here. I usually don't keep the food too often. I usually tend to sell it. Where it's red in the numbers, that shows you that's your limit to what you have. Of course, over in the left, it tells you your stock. Oh, I meant to sell that. Oh, wait. Go back in here. I'm going to press the wrong button. You watch. Short sword. I got one in stock. I'm going to sell that. This I might keep, but I got two in stock. So I don't think you can throw two. Maybe you can throw two at a time. It'd be kind of pointless because I want to have a sword, so I'm going to sell one. Bandana. I'm going to sell. Even though it says it's going to give me more defense, it's because I have the gambler glasses on right now. Sell that. Sell a fedora. Monocle gives me 20. Ballroom mask gives me 21. I'll sell the monocle. Keep the ballroom mask. Surcoat raises your defense. I'm going to keep that. Iron leggings, I'm going to keep that. Hiking boots. Sandals, sell that. The back, I only have one cape. Hoop earring, I'll sell both. Pendant, I will sell. Lucky charm, I'm going to keep because actually you can only buy those. Some items you can only buy. And let's see what else we got here. Hunter skills, I'm not too sure about because I think it's for another character. I'm not too sure exactly which character. I think I have an idea. But, okay, let's show you what's for sale. You know, potion, high potion, all this stuff here. Whenever you've beaten the first level, it shows these are what everything you can buy so far. I already have that. What's the claymore, I think, is the best or the strongest sword, at least. And let me see what else. Is anything else stronger in here right now? The claymore, as of now, is the strongest weapon. Of course, that's only attacks only up 2 more points away from this, and that's a pretty damn fast sword. Wait, 32. What's that? The lance. I sure as hell don't want that because that's probably slow as fuck. Handgun, I got. I just like handguns, and it's like the most expensive item, probably because it's the coolest, I guess. So, let's see, hats. Nothing special, just stuff that raises defense. Some clothing might raise attack, I'm not too sure. No, not here. Engineer boots. Assassin's cape's the best, I think. It raises your attack. Well, as of now. We got 2 lucky charms. If we need to raise our luck a point each, that will raise it up 2 points if we need both equipped. Flame necklace just protects you from fire. Hunter skills, not for sale, at least not to me or to my character. Exit shop. Alright, so right now we can go back out. There you can download content. Helping options, we've seen that already. Replays, leaderboards. Okay, so leaderboards. Open up the leaderboards locally. My rank is 754. That's the score. My score. And here you can watch the video of them playing. I wish they'd tell you the time limit of the video, because or else we could watch it. But then again, I don't have permission to show you their video, so maybe I should stay out of that. Let me see if I'm missing anything else. Okay, local play. Let's go into here. Change characters. Here's a different characters available right now. Alucard, Jonathan Morris. I think he's from the Genesis version, or if you want to call it Mega Drive. Genesis version of Castlevania. I can't remember exactly the title of that one. Julius Belmont. I think he's from the same series as Soma, if I'm not mistaken. Shona. And these are basically the characters you have right now. I'd like to try one with someone with a whip. That'd be pretty interesting. But, okay, well, this part here is probably not as exciting as the game itself. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and play the second chapter. Not right now, but in the next video. Or before the next video. That way I can get some practice in and buy all the items and be able to get through it fast enough to actually show you how to beat it. So anyways, folks, this is all the time I have for now. Thanks for watching Play It Again. Stay tuned for the next part. Have a good night.